This is my custom built 3D printer with a huge build volume, and thanks to this camera, I can even admire the printed filament up close. I started by designing the frame and the carriage that can move smoothly over the aluminium profiles, which will allow the X, Y and Z movements. Once the prototype had been tested and the dimensions were correct, I ordered the custom aluminium profiles and continued refining the printed parts. All 192 parts were sliced using Cura, and I used these settings to print them. I used a conventional milling machine to mill and tap the holes in the aluminium profiles for M6 socket head screws. To create the threads in printed parts, I used threaded inserts that I simply melted into the parts with a soldering iron. These are all the materials I will use to make the 3D printer. I start by attaching the screen to the holder and continue with the Z-stepper motor attachments. Now I assemble the left Z carriage containing the X stepper motor and X limit switch. Then I make the right Z carriage containing the belt tensioner for the X axis. The Y carriage is equipped with ball bearings and wheels for smooth movement along the aluminium profiles. The heated bed is secured with M4 countersink bolts, and spacers will be also added later. The aluminium plate has M4 holes and countersink holes for mounting the power supply. The frame is mounted with M6 hexagon socket screws. I make the holder for the Y stepper motor and mount it to the frame with M4 T-slot nuts. Here you can see one option of how to mount the Z limit switch. I also make the Y belt tensioner and mount it on the other side. Now I make the carriage for the X-axis, which consists of the extruder, the hot end and the fan duct. I mount the carriage for the X-axis on the X-aluminium profile and tighten the timing belt. Now I mount the Y-carriage on the Y-aluminium profiles and attach and tighten the GT2 belt. The Z-stepper motors are mounted with M4 T-slot nuts for stable mounting. To assemble the extruder tower, I carefully screw the lead screw into the lead screw nuts. I mount the aluminium plate with 6 M4 hexagon socket screws, after which the motherboard is mounted. Then I connect the motherboard to the switch and the power supply according to this diagram. And I add a cap to protect the power supply connections and connected cables of all electronics to the motherboard. Cable brackets attached to the underside of the plate for a neat finish. Before I continue with completely finishing the printer, I will first test whether it works. I do this with an XYZ cube. This is the result of the first test, and as you can see, the Z is wrong. I grease the lead screws so that there is not too much friction to allow the X profile to move in height with the extruder. Now I print the XYZ cube again, and as you can see, cube looks much better now, but it's not perfect yet. I install a magnetic circuit board with a magnetic sticker to hold it firmly in place. I also add rubber feet to reduce vibration. I use Microsoft Visual Studio Code to customize the Marlin software. I change the dimensions of the build volume, the printer information and the boot logo. I'm making a new holder with magnets to make it easier to level my print bed. I install the cable chain to protect the cables going from the extruder to the motherboard. I buy this camera module that is specially made to mount next to the warm nozzle. I made this holder for the camera module and 2 12-volt LEDs because a camera needs a lot of light to make beautiful videos. Because the camera is mounted so close to the nozzle, I can take these cool videos with it. I also add plates to the bottom of the aluminium plate for safety and to make the printer look nicer. I also add a container where I can put the nozzle camera and other tools when I'm not using them. The printer is now ready, but there were still a few issues. The cable chain added too much weight, preventing the X-axis from rising. So, I increased the driver current for the Z-stepper motor. The nozzle was not clogged, but no filament came out after 20 minutes of printing. I turned the fan on the hot end to blow cold air in, instead of blowing warm air out. This is more efficient at cooling the hot end. And now my printers worked perfect and I can finally start testing it. I started by printing a traditional test print, the 3D Banshee, and with the boat I could fine-tune my settings. After this, I printed a number of other things, including this large vase. I also printed a small version of my pen holder on 3 different 3D printers to compare my homemade printer with. Of course, making this printer didn't happen the first time, and these are all the prototypes or test prints I needed to make this printer. You can download all the files from this printer via Culls 3D. Thanks for watching, like, subscribe, and I see you in the next video.